So we have a new son named Matthew Gray East, and he was named a little bit after Daddy's brother, Gray. And we want to find out why, or something about Uncle Gray. Like, when was he born?
March 4th, 1921.
So he was younger than you by
three some years.
Okay.
Probably.
All right. And then he got married to Aunt Louise in, what did you say, August?
No, the letter
no,
was
the,
August.
The letter was August, and he got married.
He was a friend of Louise's brother-in-law in service. And when he got home from service World War II, he was introduced to Louise. They dated for a while.
What was Louise's maiden name?
Bennett.
Well, what did he do when he was in service?
He was special on the Norden bomb site, B-24 bomber. He was a crew chief.
Did he fly?
Did he fly? He was ground maintenance. He got the plane ready to go out on the bombing raids.
So he was based in Europe?
No. Where? Australia. Went up through the islands to the Philippines. Came home from the Philippines by the time I got to the Philippines.
Hmm. Why was he in service before you were?
Well, he volunteered, and he was like, chances were too good, both of them stayed home.
Hmm.
Somebody's got to go, and he said, I'm going to volunteer. So when you stay home, you'd be one of the family in.
Mm-hmm.
So he elected to.
So why did you volunteer then?
I didn't.
I thought they wouldn't draft the sole surviving son or something like that.
Well, that was a part of it. Things got tighter.
Gray was not dead, so he wasn't sole surviving
right.
Son.
Oh, okay. So they could go ahead and get you.
But, I had the farm department. My production was high enough with chicken and cow, hogs, cotton, everything else that I had. I had 16 units. A production of farm, and you had that point line that's put to the furlough. So I lasted a long time before I finally we can't get rid of the permanent loan.
So what did Gray do at the University of Georgia? He wrote
he didn't go to the University of Georgia.
Georgia State.
Oh, okay. There's a thing on here that said from the university or somewhere.
It was a division. Yeah, it was the Atlanta division.
Yeah.
Okay. University of Georgia, Atlanta division.
Okay.
It's an old name for it. He came home and got a job in the treasurer's office under, there were only a few people there, Dr. Sparks, who was the founder of Georgia State. And he went into the office then and came in short order and was the census controller for Georgia State.
And he worked for the transportation department or something like that? He only worked for Georgia State?
Yeah.
Misperceptions, I guess.
Yeah.
All right, so he met Louise somewhere in 47-ish?
No, it could be 45.
Okay.
Could have been.
Oh, they didn't even date, right.
Okay.
And then they got married in 47, 48, somewhere in there.
That's about right, I'm not sure.
And then they lived on Glenwood Road, I think, for a while. Glenwood Road.
After I left, my mother went to South McDonald Street, Kentucky, and lived there for a year or two. And when I came home, Gray had already moved out in an apartment. But when I got home and Mother and I moved out here, Gray took the apartment and lived there for a while.
For a while? So then, and that was when he went to Georgia State?
Yeah.
After he came back, so he was just there straight out of service?
Mm-hmm.
And did everything there? So, okay.
He used the GI education benefits,
yeah.
Didn't
he? Mm-hmm. Okay, so then he met, he and Louise got married in 47, 48, and then Claudia was born in 52, I would guess.
After you were born.
Yeah, so isn't she a year younger than me?
That's about right.
Yeah. Okay, so they got, and then they lived,
Glenwood,
okay, yeah. Then.
Number of years.
So Louise told us that.
Moved from there to Laguna.
Right.
Behind Richie's.
Where were they living at the time of Gray died?
I don't remember being anywhere else. I remember Dish being there.
Yeah, I do too. But Gray, I couldn't remember where they moved there before Gray died.
Yeah. Okay, so Laguna when Gray died, and he died of what?
Heart
attack. And
64, February 6. It was February 64. Hmm.
Where was he when he had a heart attack?
He was at school and went to the nurse, and she examined him and she called the doctor about it. Says, look, says, I think he's having such and such a symptom. And the doctor says, well, can't you feel it? He says, I think it's something worse. I think you ought to check him. And so somebody is taking him to the hospital, said he was discussing how to fix washing machines and this, that, and that, and got him on the table at the hospital. And he asked about the doctor.
Had he had any heart problems before that?
High blood pressure. It wouldn't let him out of the army.
Why was he so big into repairing things? I mean, why was he big into TVs and all that kind of stuff?
Mechanical.
Was he the one that brought the TV set here one time, the first TV set here? As I remember it being.
I think Grandpa, my dad did the first TV set.
Yeah, walked all one down with her junior preacher.
She was great about me.
Okay, but Gray brought it down, but that was just to sort of show what a TV was, and then her daddy maybe gave us one.
Gave us our first.
Yeah, but the one I remember from Gray had a sort of oval picture tube or something like that. I don't know if it's my memory of it. I don't remember what we saw or anything like that. But I just remember being some sort of big golden box with an oval tube in it. And having a basement and having all the Jim Crash in the corner of the basement over there. There's a little repair shop, a repair place over there.
He was good with mechanics and sewing machines. He could fix sewing machines and he could sew. So, remember that part?
Mm-hmm. Well pumped. Time for the chicken house slide.
A handy kind of guy, yeah.
He worked the bit with Jack over there. He was a man. Georgia State. Mm-hmm. What is that, Georgia State?
Do you remember, do you have any memories of him as a boy, or escapades, or stories, or? give me some telling examples of Gray's personality. This little Gray know what his name says.
He was a few brothers. We were pretty close. We were close. Did well in school.
Where did he graduate from?
Gray County High. 37th grade. I've been a salutator in that class.
Well, if I can interrupt here a little bit, because I think I talked to Frank's mother more than Frank did about when she got married. She was talking about Miss Reeves after she married and said that first he said, we don't want to have any children, do we? She said, well, they need to get married unless they're going to have children. But anyhow, it came time for them to go to school, and she said that Mr. Reeves' first family had not graduated from high school. And she told her husband, says, my boys are going to go to school. And she picked cotton to be sure that they had the money to graduate from school. Very conscientious about her children.
And so she would pick cotton where? Around here or down in the apple?
I was growing cotton.
Yeah.
See, when I was 18 years old, 15 years, still in school, when I was out of school and farming.
Where at?
Oh, that's just little fields around here, behind the church. here, where the farm market is now.
Mm-hmm.
And there, on top of the hill, the tallest place is. There, and there, behind the New Hope Methodist Church.
There. How'd you get the little cactus?
Well, people are there.
There were you? Mm-hmm. You asked them, did you have them to grow cotton?
Yeah, but you rent a house.
Yeah, rent
the land.
Yeah,
yeah. Dr. Chambers lived in the house here where Zephyrus lived in later years.
Mm-hmm.
He really was the first one. My dad had, he was his horse, his crop, and he was managing that the first 2 years, I guess, here. But Dr. Chambers just talked to him one day. Son, if you want to, we were planning patch the cotton together and we'll make a bale of cotton. I'll find some fertilizer and seed and all of everything cost any money. You just do the labor and we'll divide it. I did. Also, I went to one of my projects was to go to Woolsey, the house where my grandpa lived. The man who lived there was Coons, K-O-O-N-S, and he was very poor. And had money at that time. Nobody had any money to spend. He would hire me to lead my horse down, and he'd come and put plastic on his car, tied on somewhere, and go down and I'd lead the horse down, fly his garden. He'd pay me $1 or $2. Mm-hmm. I'd get rich for that. Nobody paid that sort of money. I'd 75 cents to work all day, and I worked 2 hours, he'd give me $1. But I really didn't call him. He didn't like the farm. And, as soon as he was out of high school, he went to Atlanta to work for him. So they married at first. She got the first job for him at Southern Salt Service. And he, again, machined upkeep for him and so on there. And then after a while, he moved into the house with Melvin Pitts, who I believe took him, they had three daughters, but they had a big house. And he had three boys and boys there too. And he took me and made him part of the family.
Where was that? The first
on Regent Street behind Clue Peabody Harrah Church Factory in Lakewood.
And where was the Southwest? Is it the same Lakewood?
Probably Fortnum on Eddins Drive, of course, Fortnum first.
Sure.
Another example of Gray's mechanical ability. Mr. Pitts had a project. This would have been now when there was field rationing going on. And I. That may have even been